Hey everyone, Sam from PMTV UK here, and in this video we're looking at five different ways that you can use an AB or ABY splitter pedal. So this week I've been filming a guide on multi-amp guitar rigs which utilise this type of splitter unit. So if you did want to go a bit more in depth into how to connect up multiple amplifiers, make sure to go and check out that video. But I thought it might also be handy to shoot a quick companion vid just to give you a couple more ways that you can use an AB or ABY box. Just in case you don't know what I'm talking about, an AB box is a simple switching unit which has a single input for a guitar or other instrument and then two outputs and a switch which allows you to direct the signal to either output A or output B. An ABY box does pretty much the same thing, but it also allows you to select both outputs at the same time, effectively splitting the input signal to be sent to different destinations. So use number one, amp selecting. If you're a guitarist, you might already own a couple of different amplifiers and you'll probably have your preferred amp depending on the tone that you need. For example, historically Fenders are renowned for their clean tones, whilst Marshalls offer that legendary overdrive. With a simple AB box, you can have the best of both worlds as it allows you to connect your guitar to both amps, switching between the Fender for your cleans and the Marshall for your lead tone. Use number two. If you've got an ABY box, along with that switching, you can also send your guitar signal to both amps simultaneously, great for blending tones together. So again, using our Marshall and Fender as an example, we can get a nice gritty, mid-rangey crunch tone from the Marshall, but if we blend in the clean from the Fender, it adds a nice layer of high-end shimmer to the mix, increasing note definition. Now it is worth mentioning that if you are using amplifiers simultaneously like this, you'll definitely need to use a switching box which has got isolated outputs to stop ground loops from forming between the amps, which can cause loud buzzing, hum and other unwanted noises. And to avoid phase issues between the amps, make sure the splitter has got a phase invert switch. Now I'm not going to go into the science behind it here, but these features are really important when running multiple amps together. You won't find these kind of specs on a cheap ABY box, so we'd definitely recommend checking out something like the Amp Detonator by Orange. Use number three, wet dry guitar amp rigs. Now this is where we're using effects pedals in conjunction with two amplifiers, but only certain types of effects are sent to certain amplifiers. When talking about wet dry setups, effects such as drive pedals are referred to as dry effects, whilst modulations, reverbs and delays are generally considered to be wet effects. So for example, the guitar signal firstly goes into the overdrive pedal. The signal is then split using the ABY box. Again, make sure it's got isolated outputs and can handle phasing. The A output goes directly to our first amplifier, known as the dry amp, whilst the B output goes into our wet effects before hitting the second amplifier, known as the wet amp. This way, both amps get the signal from your guitar and the overdrive pedal, but only the wet amp gets the modulation, delay and reverb signal as well. The thinking behind this is that any definition that might have been lost by adding the wet effects is brought back into the mix with the introduction of the dry amp, helping to maintain note clarity and meaning that your playing will sound less mushy without actually having to lose those wet effects. Thank you. Use number four, the always-on guitar tuner. Now, some guitar tuner pedals do already have an always-on function, meaning that you can tune up without actually having to turn them on and off. But to do this, they will introduce a buffer into your signal chain. Now, if you're a tone purist and you just want to hear the sound of your guitar going directly into your amp, a buffer in a pedal can subtly alter your tone. If you use an ABY splitter box though, you can split the signal between your amp and tuner, maintaining that true bypass hardwired connection between guitar and amplifier, but the tuner will still constantly be receiving a signal and can be left always on. Plus, in AB mode, you also still have the option to switch the signal to just the tuner, so you can tune up silently, meaning that you can also use the AB box as a mute switch for your guitar. It is probably worth mentioning though, that some splitters, such as the Orange Amp Detonator, do feature a buffered output. So if you're looking to avoid this, just go for a simple, cheap, unbuffered, passive switching unit. Finally, use number five, input switching. Now, so far, we've only really talked about switching and splitting an output signal. But with a basic AB or ABY box, that signal can go in the opposite direction. Now, the obvious use for this would be if you've only got one amp at a gig, but you need to regularly change between two guitars. With an AB box, you can have both guitars permanently connected, meaning that you only have to flick a switch when you're changing guitars to send the correct signal to your amp, and you don't need to unplug anything, making guitar changes really quick and easy. An ABY box will also allow you to blend two guitar outputs into a single amp input, which I wouldn't always recommend as this can cause a bit of a mismatch in impedances, so it's probably not a great idea to do this with your boutique valve combo, for instance. But let's say you're a guitar teacher using a cheap transistor amp, this can offer an easy way for both you and your student to play through a single amp at the same time during a lesson. This input switching method can also be really handy if you're into live looping, where time is of the essence when it comes to building loops. If you use an AB box connected to the input of your looper, it'll allow you to quickly switch between two input sources, so let's say a guitar and a bass, allowing for much more efficient loop layering. Thanks for watching. That was five ways that you can use an AB or ABY box. I hope that's given you a few ideas, and if you can think of any other uses, please do leave them in the comments below. Now, there is one switcher that's definitely worth an honorary mention, and that's the Boss LS2 line selector. I didn't feature it in the video because it's kind of much more than just a standard ABY box, but if you did want even more options, such as the ability to change the volumes of the outputs or to switch or blend between loops of effects pedals, great for running effects in parallel, then it's definitely worth taking a look at. To check out all of our switchers, visit pmtonline.co.uk or get down to your nearest professional music technology store. As always, don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram as PMT House of Rock. And if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, please do give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, ring the notifications bell, and I'll see you on the next video.